Welcome back. My name's Gracie and I will be your cruise attendant for today. So booking cruises and shore excursions and tours like that can be a crazy, pretty hectic job, especially when you do it while you're on the boat. Is it worth it? I would say yeah. Shore excursions and tours can be an amazing way to explore the places that you're going to whilst knowing that you're safe and having everything provided to you. So today I will be telling you guys all the tips and tricks I use when booking shore excursions and tours. So the tips I'm telling you today are from my experience with Royal Caribbean, though I'm sure they can be like applied to other cruise liners as well. But quickly, if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe down below. Your support helps us bring you guys more travel tips and helps us grow the channel. If you have any questions, be sure also to comment down below. So let's get started. I've been traveling with Royal Caribbean for pretty much the last 4 years. I've been on 5 cruise tours, so I may not be a complete expert, but I have a couple of tips for you guys. So explaining what shore excursions and tours pretty much are, when you're traveling around to ports while on a cruise, there are the options to undertake shore excursions and tours, and they can be to like some really amazing places. You'll be surprised at the amount of tours that are available. So you can go to vanilla plantations in like Vanuatu, you can go explore volcanoes in Hawaii, you can go to Hobbiton in New Zealand. Like, there's some really cool tours available. Normally, traditionally, you go onto the boat, you would sit down in front of them and you would be like, well, I want to go here and here, can you give me a number once you've like arrived on the cruise? But this is where it gets interesting, because a lot of time when you go that traditional route, you often miss out on the tours that you would like to attend. For example, the first year that my family and I went traveling to New Zealand on a cruise, we wanted to go to Hobbiton so badly. Like, that was our goal. That was pretty much the whole reason we were going on this cruise, just to go to Hobbiton, because we are massive Lord of the Rings fans. And we pretty much got on the boat. We didn't even go to our stateroom first. We went straight to the desk and we're like, we want to go to Hobbiton. And they're like, it's already sold out. And we're like, we literally just walked on the boat. This was our first stop. Like, we hadn't gone to our stateroom, we hadn't looked around all excited, we'd gone straight to the tour desk and it was already sold out. So here I'm going to tell you how to find the tours that you want to go on, how to make sure they're safe and they're relevant for you, and how to actually get them booked instead of missing out. After that, of course, we went through a third party that the cruise recommended, and it was amazing, it was heaps of fun, and I'll always remember that for the rest of my life. But yes, here we go. So first tip, book before. This may sound interesting because I just told you that once you get on the cruise, then you go to the desk. But no, you actually have the option to be able to go onto your ship's website. So say there's Royal Caribbean, you can select the cruise that you're going on, and usually there's like a sub tab for tours and shore excursions. Then through there, you can actually explore all the tours that will be available for your cruise dates, and you can actually even book. Like, oh my goodness. Sometimes you can actually get them for even discounted prices. I remember when I had to book online before, I got 25% off one of my packages one time. So yes, stalk around, get a couple of ideas. You can get discounts. It's awesome. I know this is amazing, but also keep in mind that very popular tours may not be able to be booked. So for example, last year I was looking through some of the tours for Vanuatu, where we went, you can see our vlogs below, and we found this amazing zip lining tour. And I was like, oh my goodness, zip lining at like Vanuatu, or maybe it was Fiji, I can't remember. I was like, I wanna do that so bad, but there wasn't the option to book. And this is because the cruise knows that this will be a very popular tour. So avoiding having to discount it, they can get everyone to rush onto the boat and all pay full price. It's pretty sneaky, but to be fair, we're already trying to exploit the system, so. So you found the booking page for your cruise specific, wait, so you found the booking page for your specific cruise. You found the tours that are listed by port. You can select each day and they'll show you the available tours for that date. But now you've got to decide what tours you actually want to do. Keep in mind that tours cost money, and that cost of money can actually rise exponentially when you are planning your tours. The cheapest tour that I've actually found cost about $65 per person. But it's not rare to see some tours actually costing up to $250, $350 per person. To determine what shore excursions and tours I actually want to go on, I've actually set a list of criteria that I use when determining that. So number one, is it actually interesting? For me, I wouldn't go to a winery or go on a wine tasting tour because I'm not a big drinker. I mean, if you're going to spend $200 per person on a cheese tour, you've got to be pretty interested in cheese. But if your tour includes amazing waterfalls and snorkeling or zip lining or like skydiving, you bet I'm gonna be interested. My second criteria that I normally use is, can I do it myself? When I know we keep using last year, but I was in Fiji last year and we didn't book a tour. We're like, oh yeah, we'll just go around in the city and we'll explore kind of thing. But we turned up and there was these bus tickets, right? $12 per person, actually $9 per person. And you got to go, there was buses running every 15 minutes and you could actually go on these buses and go to all the beaches and see all the sights by yourself for $15 per person. And I'm sure the same cruise costed it about $85 per person. So can you do it yourself? I'd normally recommend doing this route for larger cities and really packed in areas like your big cities, like, I don't know, Toronto and Auckland and Wellington, etc. Because a lot of the sites are really packed in. For more rural areas, I would usually recommend going with a tour, but in saying that, we've probably just wandered around a couple of times and that's all been fine. My third criteria would be, is the tour a safer alternative to doing it myself? We have arrived at some pretty crazy ports and there's like security and then there's police at the security barriers. But then after that, there's like a thick line of people all yelling and shouting at you like, do you want a bus tour and stuff like that? Bus tours for like $10. That's the worst impersonation ever. But in those cases, it's a little bit freaky for people who aren't accustomed to that and those who weren't mentally prepared for that. So keep in mind, is the tour a safer alternative? You know, you can't place a price on human life, right? But maybe it's that extra $80, that extra $50 kind of idea to make sure that you're safe and not risking your life. I think losing a part of you, like your leg, or losing someone that you love is a lot more costly than just paying for a tour. Now, I'm not saying don't get into locals, support them. Locals and stuff like that. And it's just that the tours provided by the cruise liner have been third party approved. They've been approved by the crews themselves. They've made sure that they're safe. They've made sure that they're like environmentally friendly, etc. So by going on a cruise provided tour, you know that you're being safe. And probably number four that we consider, is there a meal available? Consider this. Most ports have about 8 to 10 hours where you're available to wander around. That's a lot of time not eating. I'm going to be honest, that's a long time not eating. You often don't want to risk yourself eating local food, especially if it's like third world country. I mean, if you're in like New Zealand or like America or Canada and stuff like that, obviously you're safe. But I've been to a lot of like more countries with like less health standards pretty much. And especially if you're not allowed to take food off of the boat or onto the boat, it's like, or someone's gonna get a little bit hungry kind of idea. If you can risk eating the local food, go ahead, all props to you. But when we're booking a tour, we consider if it has a meal or any kind of food. And sometimes it's worth that extra money doing that instead of buying locally, which may be more expensive. After all of this, we normally limit our shore excursions just to like 2 or 3 maximum if there are some really amazing sites that we want to see. For example, we went on a cruise throughout New Zealand. There was 5 ports and we only had a book tour for one of those in Wellington. The Weta Digital tour is amazing. And then we also did a third party one through the cruise. Normally, if we're on a Christmas cruise, we'll normally do a Christmas Day cruise, but that's up to you and how you want to bracket that. So be sure to book your shore excursions and your tours in advance. To book on board, if you miss out online, You often have to go to the shore excursion desk. It's right next to the general information desk, and it's normally in like the main plaza of the cruise ship. Be sure to go to the shore excursion desk as soon as possible. There's often a long line of people waiting there. Sometimes you can wait up to like half an hour, 45 minutes, because it's that popular, especially on the first day. It's usually our first port of call. Oh, see what I did there? If you are booking online and selecting your tours online, be sure to do it so as early as possible. They can lock them off like anywhere between 24 to 48 hours. I've seen some cruisers book them off up to like 3 or 4 days in advance. So maybe about a month in advance is good. That's probably my happy medium, getting excited for the cruise, but also having like money still left. Also, make sure your tour is interesting to you. There is no point in going to the history of papermaking if you are not a paper fanatic. Likewise, tours with natural sights and interesting things like zip lining and sports and stuff like that also book out very quickly because they're often family friendly. Watch out for that. Make sure your tour is within your budget. Tours are fun and all, but they are freaking expensive, as well as the cost of, you know, going on the cruise. So make sure that your tour is beneficial to you. Is it going to a private island? Is it taking you somewhere that you wouldn't be able to access by yourself? Is my tour a safer alternative to doing it by myself? I mean, wandering the streets is always a little bit dodgy. It depends on the average traveler and yourself about how confident you are. Often I would say that a tour outweighs the emotional and possible cons of going by yourself, but like I said, we went to 5 ports and we only did 2 tours. Leave time to explore for yourself. Overbooking is often the bane of a traveler's existence, to be honest. And give yourself time and whoever you're traveling with to go and explore. Actually go and experience the world instead of through like a pipelined version of it. So do your best to keep your tours to a minimum. They aren't essential. It depends on each traveler. While I was on a cruise last year, I met a couple, an elderly couple, who've been together forever on 52 cruises. Like, they've been on 52 individual cruises, and they'd only ever been on a tour once in Egypt. So it's totally up to you. It's totally up to your skill set and budget, etc. If you are on a budget, consider tours very carefully. It's something that you'll need to talk about with whoever you're traveling with and make sure it's within your financial means. So that's pretty much all my travel tips for tours and shore excursions. If you have any questions, be sure to comment down below and we'll get back to you ASAP. As always, be sure to subscribe as it supports us, and even consider donating to our Patreon so we can continue bringing all these tips to you. That's all. Thanks for watching.